Hello everyone, my name is Mary Mwendwa. I'm a freelance journalist based in Nairobi, Kenya. I'm also an online editor for a publication known as Talk Africa, which is owned by the Association of Freelance Journalists. Today I'm going to do a presentation titled The Story Behind Women Joining Extremist Groups in Kenya. So what comes in your mind when you talk about women and extremism? Women play multiple roles both within violent extremist groups and also play a role in preventing and countering violent extremism. However, very little is known about women and violent extremism in the context of Kenya. So this story aims to investigate insights into the roles that women play in relation to violent extremism in Kenya, the gendered impacts of radicalization and violent extremism, and the efficacy of current responses to violent extremism in relation to women. So what about the story? Maybe let me talk about a little background of the story. I won this award to do a story in one of Kenya's informal settlements known as Majengo, where a lot of Al-Shabaab recruitment happens. So this is an area where stories of people who've joined Al-Shabaab, stories of people who've disappeared, stories of people who've been killed, stories of people who are still looking for their loved ones, suspecting maybe they have joined Al-Shabaab. So the story on the role of women and how they play in extremism came as a result of an award that was given to me by AWIM during their forum last year, through the support of African Union and GIZ under the AU's project of Agenda 2063 in line with the theme of silencing the guns. So what approach did I use to get information around this story? I used the quantitative research type of approach to allow me gather a lot of information around this sensitive topic of women and extremism. So what was the justification? I realized that women in Majengo, especially in Kenya, play a role in preventing and promoting violent extremism in the region. So their roles cannot be ignored because they have huge impacts in the fight against violent extremism. So what was the methodology that I used? I have talked about that earlier. I used focus group discussions where I met a women group and other people during my interviews, and I also did one-on-one interviews, and also I did a lot of research by reading a lot of articles and publications around women and extremism in Kenya. So when we talk of Majengo, an informal settlement in east of Nairobi, what comes in your mind? Majengo is an informal settlement like just any other, where people struggle with crime, people struggle with basic needs, people struggle with sanitation, people struggle with housing and all that. This is a photo I took in Majengo using a phone because I could not even carry a big camera due to security reasons, due to people feeling intimidated and all that. So I used a phone to take this picture. As you can see, someone is pushing, we call it a mkokoteni, and on the sides you can see some buildings, and then ahead you can see a tall white building. This is a landmark in the area, a very famous mosque, and this mosque is always on the spotlight because the security agencies in Kenya usually have information about recruitments and all that, so they always target this mosque. So this mosque is always on the radar. Most times they are always targeted. Sometimes you find security agencies surrounding the mosque. Maybe they are looking for a person, they are looking for someone they feel that is a recruitee, is a recruit of Al-Shabaab, or they feel the person has links with Al-Shabaab. So it's a mosque that has a lot of stories, but people here still believe in it. They go there for prayers and all that. So what did I discover when I was doing this story? I discovered a lot of things around women and extremism. And I realized that the role women play in extremism cannot be ignored. They play a critical role in the fight against extremism. Also, as much as they play a critical role in fighting against extremism, I discover that women are still perpetrators of extremism activities, especially for the Al-Shabaab group. Women are still recruited. Women are used as spies. And I realize that they are less targeted in programs around extremism. So women are still at the center of extremism recruitments, especially Al-Shabaab. This is a group that I interviewed and I did a lot of group discussions with them. It is a group based in Majengo and in a self-help group known as Omul self-help group that is doing a lot of work with women, helping them to understand issues around extremism, helping them to do table banking so that they're economically empowered, helping them to be on the look on how their children behave, and all that. So these women have stood out in Majengo, and they are an example of women who are helping in fight against extremism. So where was this story published? This story was published on Talk Africa, and it was titled "Women: Why Women Matter in Fighting Extremism." It was published on 20th April this year. So what challenges did I face while doing this story? Remember, this was a story around security, and it was a story that was had an investigative nature. So some sources were not willing to be photographed or interviewed. The security team was not willing to give me an interview. There was issues to do with personal security because this is an informal settlement where there is a lot of gangs, there are a lot of crime and all that. And then there was this issue of lack of trust by the community, because any stranger that steps in Majengo, they feel they are spying. So what was the impact of the story? After I did this story, many journalists in Kenya fear going to Majengo because there have been stories where journalists have been attacked, journalists have been targeted, and then there's a lot that is going on in Majengo in terms of extremism. So people fear, even our journalists fear going to do stories there. But after I did this story, journalists within my circles, they started getting more and more interested to go and feature Majengo, especially women. And then there's an organization that is known as CACPEN. This organization was very helpful to me because it was an organization that helped me to be able to access Majengo. Through them, I was to get to Omul self-help group and other people that I interviewed. So this organization was recently awarded by the United Nations General Assembly. They were awarded for their efforts in promoting peace and stability during the UNGA conference in New York. So this is a positive thing that came from Majengo, and I was happy because I was associated with CACPEN when doing the stories around women and extremism in Majengo. Thank you so much. And that is another picture also for Majengo. This is how Majengo looks like when it rains. There's a lot of mud. It's not easy to navigate. So thank you so much.